landforms, which resulted as the formation of a landforms to the internal movements. Internal movements. So our chapter is based upon a plate tectonics, the concept of a plate tectonics. Plate tectonics. Plate tectonics. This concept of a plate tectonic, it has based upon a such lithospheric portions of the earth, means plates, such crustal spaces over of the earth, crustal surfaces of the earth. So lithospheric portions of earth crust, which has divided into islands and continents. Islands and continents is known as plate tectonics. They are known as the plate tectonics. There are broadly the 7 large plates and 15 smaller plates. 15 smaller plates. So the 7 large plates are constitutes the 7 continents of the world. 7 continents of the world, which includes Pacific plate, North American plate, Eurasian plate, etc. Clear? Among these, all these lithospheric plates, these are floating above of the semi-molten magma. Semi-molten magma. Semi-molten means that it is not as a that part of a magma which has constitutes under the volcanic eruptions. It is a semi-molten magma. Above of these, all these lithospheric portions, the land surfaces, they are floating. They are floating above of the such lithosphere, such semi-molten magma. Understood? Semi-molten magma. Due to the floating above of a liquid material, that magma, these plates collide with each other. They move towards each other, which is known as the convergent movements. Convergent movements. When two plates, they move towards each other, due to the displacement, they are known as the convergent movements. Convergent movements are resulting as the, they are the result of the compressional forces. They are the result of compressional forces. When the plates come towards each other, the movement is known as the convergent. When two plates come together, they may form either collide and crumble, or one may slide under the other. Under the other is known as convergent movements. At times, they may also move horizontally past over one another. They are resulting as the fold mountains. Convergent movements are resulting as the fold mountains, because two plates move towards each other, which compressing the material, it compresses the material which has present in between of such two large lithospheric portions. Clear? Second are the divergent movements. When two plates move away from each other, is known as divergent movements. They are known as the divergent movements. In a divergent movement, they are destructive in nature, which are the result of a tension. Divergent movements are the result of a tensional forces, because two plates move away from each other, and cause the depressions on a surface of earth crust. Due to the movement of such plates, depressions and rift valleys came into existence. Rift valleys came into existence. And third is a transform movements. Transform movements. When two different plates slides in opposite direction, or either overlap one upon other is known as a transform movements. They are known as the transform movements. So transform movements, they are the constructive as well as destructive. They are constructive as well as destructive, but they are the result of the tensional forces. Due to the movement of a plates in a same direction, in opposite direction, or either when the two plates overlap each other, due to this, the tension creates on a surface, which visualizes in a form of a cracks. On a surface of the earth crust, there are cracks are appeared. Cracks are appeared is known as the transform tectonic movements. Transform tectonic movements. A chapter which has based on as the physical divisions, the major physical divisions of India, they are the basically the result of these three tectonic movements. Convergent movement, in which two plates move towards each other. Second are the divergent movements, in which the two plates move away from each other. And transform movements, when two different plates slides in opposite direction, they slides in a opposite direction, or either moves in the same direction. Or third condition as a sometimes they overlap, one upon other overlaps. So these movements are known as a transform movements. Transform movements are the constructive as well as destructive in nature. Constructive, when one plate overlaps the other plate, through which as the block mountains came into existence. When two block mountains, these are the result of the overlapping of plates, due to which as the rift valleys are also came into existence. Rift valleys also form on a surface of the earth crust. Look towards here. If we assume this is as the strata, these are the layers, different layers of the earth. When we move from a crust towards their interiors, different layers are there. When two plates, they overlap each other, there will be as the cracks will appear. Cracks appear on the surface of the earth. And when these cracks, they will widen, then under such circumstances, some portion, the interior portion of a structure or a strata, it will subside downward. And the remaining two highlands, they will known as the block mountains. Look towards here. Block mountains. So same type of layers which are lies in a different. This portion has a subsided due to the overlapping of plates. Overlapping of plates, two different plates. Clear? The higher portion of a block mountain is known as the block mountain is known as a horst, H-O-R-S-T, horst. And a subsided portion, the downward portion, is known as a graben, G-R-A-B-B-E-N, graben. And complete of this is known as the block mountain. This is the block mountain. Vosges in Europe is an example of a block mountain. Vosges, V-O-S-G-E-S, V-O-S-G-E-S, or Rift Valley in Africa. Rift Valley is the result of it. Rift Valley, that part of interior part of a block mountain which has subsided downward, that portion has mixed as a valley. That is known as the valley. Understood? Is that clear? Any doubts till there? Any doubts? If you are having any questions, any queries regarding it, you can ask. Otherwise, we will proceed. We will proceed towards the six broader physical divisions of India. First, Northern Mountains. Second, as the Great Plains of India. The Great Plains of India. Third, Peninsular Plateau. Fourth, Peninsular Plateau. Fourth, Coastal Plains. Fifth, Islands, Indian Islands. There are two groups of islands in Arabian Sea, Lakshadweep Islands, which are the group of 36 islands. And in the other side, in a Bay of Bengal, Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Clear? And sixth, the Great Indian Desert, Thar Desert. Indian Desert or Thar Desert. So these are the broader six categories of a physical divisions of India. Northern Mountains, they are also known as the Great Himalayas. Second, the Great Plains of India, Ganga Brahmaputra Plains. Third, Peninsular Plateau. Fourth one is the Coastal Plains. Fifth, Islands. And sixth, Deserts. Let's start from the first, Northern Mountains or Himalayas. Himalayas, where the Himalayas now presently is situated, north of India, 2400 kilometer stretch mountain range, which begins from the Sulaiman Mountains in Pakistan towards the east of the country in Purvanchal Hills. So the Northern Mountains, these are extended, Himalayas are extended. We are now presently as the Himalayas, they are situated. In our past, in a past of a Earth, history of Earth, at that place, there was as a water body, it was present. It proved to the that water body, their fossils, which excavated by the geologists from the surfaces of Himalayas, through which it proved that earlier the such material, which now presently in Himalayas, in the highest mountain peaks of the world, that part, such material, their rock particles, these were the part of the sea, ocean creatures. At earlier, around 2 billion years ago, all over the whole of the world, it was divided. It was basically existed in a form of a large continent named as a Pangaea. It was named as Pangaea. And Pangaea surrounded by the water body named as Panthalassa. PANTHALASA, Panthalassa. This concept of a drifting of a continents given by the Alfred Wegener. Alfred Wegener, it was given this that concept of a drifting of continents. Drifting of continents, continental drift theory. This was given by the Alfred Wegener, in which he proved earlier there was as a mass continent named as a Pangaea, which surrounded by the water body named as Panthalassa. Panthalassa, due to the internal movements of the earth, Pangaea disintegrated into the two parts. Divided into the two parts. Their northern part, known as the term used by the Wegener in context of a northern part as Angara land. It was as Angara land, and a southern portion of a Pangaea known as the Gondwana land. It was known as the Gondwana land. Due to the regular internal movements, these two mass continents came into existence. Angara land as a northern portion, which constitutes the current continents of North America, Eurasia, Europe, and Asia. And Gondwana land constitutes the parts of South America, Africa, Australia, Antarctica, and Indian Peninsula, earlier it was a part of a Gondwana land. Because of a rock composition of a rocks which are present in a peninsular plateau, these are same found in a parts of Australia also. Australia's northwestern parts. Yes, Dhiren. Pangaea. So internal movements. So these two in between offer these two due to the disintegration or a movement in a two different directions. Angara land, which moved towards the north, and Gondwana land, which moved towards the south. Due to their movement, the depression which created in between of these two large continents, it was filled with the water of a Panthalassa named as Tethys Sea, it was present on a same place, on that particular place where now presently the Himalayas are there, on same place as the Tethys Sea, it was present in our past. Clear? So internal movements which continuously work in a Pleistocene age around 40 million years ago, due to which these two large continents again disintegrated and moved towards the different directions. Due to their movement, the present map of the world came into existence. When Angara land and the Gondwana land, these were disintegrated, divided due to the internal movements of the earth. These two mass continents again further divided and moved towards the different directions, due to which the present continents of the world came into existence. But little bit behind, due to as the existence of these two Angara and Gondwana land, internal movements are convergent tectonic movements. When they start, Angara land shifted towards the south, Gondwana land shifted towards the north. Due to their movement, the number of sediments which were present in a Tethys Sea, these were as the result of a depositional work of such rivers which flow in a Angara and a Gondwana line. Every year they brought large quantities of sand, silt, sediments and deposited in a Tethisi. Deposited in Tethisi. When Angara land started to move towards south and Gondwana land towards the north. Under such circumstances, the convergent movements, the types of the sediments which were present in a Tethisi, the types of sediments which were deposited by the rivers of Angara land and Gondwana land, such sediments, on the surface of such sediments, folds were appear. F-O-L-D-S. Folds were appear. Folds were appear on such sediments which deposited by the rivers of Angara land and Gondwana land continuously for millions of the years. Folds appears on a sediments which present in Tethisi. Such folds which visualize at present are known as the Himalayas. They are known as the Himalayas. When Himalayas rises up in a Tethisi, their southern portions, the lower portions, these were lesser, these were as the leveled areas. Such leveled areas, these were filled with the more sediments by the rivers and to which as great plains of India came into existence. Great plains of India came into existence. Then again, southward areas, the parts of a Gondwana land, when it disintegrated, their parts which shifted towards a different direction. The portion of a Gondwana land, which joined to the dead part of Himalayas, now presently is known as a peninsular plateau, which is rich in minerals. Peninsular plateau in India, the southern plateau is known for their minerals because that part of India, it is a part of old Gondwana land. Old Gondwana land, which constitutes the large number of fossils. Those fossils of plants and animals which were decomposed beneath the layers of earth crust for millions of the years. They transform into the minerals. So that's why we call India is rich in natural resources. Natural resources. India is rich in natural resources. Coal, iron ore, bauxite, nickel. So such kind of the materials are found. The minerals are found in abundance in our country. In our country, the crude oil also found. It's also exact beneath the layers of earth crust. In three of the areas are there. Ankleshwar in Gujarat, Digboi in Assam, and Bombay High in Arabian Sea. These three places in India are known for the extraction of crude oil and natural gas. Because that landmass, it is the part of peninsular plateau, is the part of old Gondwana land. Is that clear? Old Gondwana land. Till there, any questions? Yes. Pranay, raise your hand. Pranay.